All right, so you're on a perfect trip or vacation. You've been waiting for this for a long time. You've got your camera with you, and you're excited about taking some cool pictures. Finally, you come across a spot that just inspires you, and you're getting ready to take that picture, but those darn tourists are just always in the way and won't get out of the way. And then just when you get ready and you find a perfect little spot, no one's there, bust out the camera, getting ready to hit that shutter, another person walks in the way. What do we do? Well, there's only one way to morally actually remove people. And the best way to do that is to do it through our photo editor in the develop module of Zoner Photo Studio X. And in this video, I'm going to show you exactly how we can get rid of those tourists and make that photo look great as if it were in some kind of catalog. So let's go take a look. Okay, so again, in this video, we're gonna show you how to remove any unwanted tourists or just people from your landscape photos, etc., using some simple retouching in the develop module. So after opening Zoner Photo Studio X, I'm opening the photo that I want to edit in the develop module. And I'd like to mention that before you dive into something like this, it's good to note that this is not something you're gonna wanna do with every picture, nor is every photograph you take actually good enough or where it makes sense to actually do this edit. Some examples are going to be photos with longer focal lengths and a dull perspective, and especially with photos that have a lot of extra people, because then you can have a lot of extra work and you don't want to do that. It takes a lot of time. An ideal photo for this type of editing is similar to this one that we have right here. One that has a easy or uniform surface in the background that blends in. And I'm going to use the retouching tools to edit this photo. They're found here under the bandage icon. And we have a choice of the healing brush and a clone stamp. So the healing brush is not exactly ideal for this type of editing because it doesn't copy texture, but rather transfers it. It blends the colors and exposure from the target area, and I'll show you how to do that now. Using Control C, I select the source area and cover up the person. Here you can see what happened. Okay, so the person's covered up, but the color doesn't really match the background. And that's because we use the color around the target area. So from this area right here. And that is the main reason why it just doesn't fit. You can tell it's been edited or blurred. Something's up. So the healing brush, as I said before, is not the best tool for this type of adjustment. However, it works great for skin retouching because that's when we need to sample colors from around the target area. Okay, so what's actually going to work well for us here? So the best tool for this purpose is using the second tool from the retouching tools, and that is the clone stamp. Now the clone stamp copies the exact selected area and pastes it on to the target area of the photo. And before we get into any further editing, I'm going to show you a little trick. One of the people in this photo was covered using the healing brush, and instead of deleting the adjustment, I just clicked on the edited area and then clone stamped it. And as you can see, the covered area actually adapted to the function of the tool that I've selected. By the way, this arrow shows you exactly where we copied the background from and where we pasted it to you. So you can have a nice overview and you know exactly where it's picking up that information and where it's placing it. Now that I have the clone stamp selected, I'll decrease the brush diameter like this and increase blur to make the retouching look just a bit more natural. All right, so I'm gonna select the sky here and use it to remove this person's body. And then I select the area where the sky and cliff come together. And I use this sample to cover the person's legs. If I only copied the sky, I might overdo it and mess up on the edge of the cliff. And you probably wouldn't see it if I went over the cliff's edge when zoomed out, but if I had a different photo where I'm removing people that are in the foreground, then these little mistakes would be much more visible. So it's best to be extremely careful, taking your time when zooming in and covering up people. Okay, so I've removed almost everybody from my photo, but I actually decided that I want to leave a person just for size comparison to give the viewer a kind of intention or let them know and realize how big that cliff actually is. Okay, now I can export. Choose my format, and I'm done. I hope this video was useful for you in the fact that next time you go on your trip or vacation, you don't get discouraged by having those pesky tourists in your shots, because now you know how to easily get rid of them, or like our example here, keep one for a size comparison. It's all up to you. All right, let us know what you think in the description below. Leave us a comment, give us a follow, and hit that bell so that you don't miss any videos from our upcoming videos. And I forgot to mention, there is more in our online magazine, learn.zoner.com, where you can find out a bit more about how to remove people or objects you don't like from your photographs, and much, much more. So take a look. See you in the next video. Till then, take care.